Today's objective is that students will be able to verify trig identities by applying other trig identities. Okay, so now let's review all of the trig identities that you should know or have written down. So we have the ratio identities. And that comprises of tan theta equals sine theta over cosine. And cotangent theta equals cosine theta over sine theta. And we have reciprocal identities. That has cosecant equals 1 over sine theta, secant theta equals 1 over cosine theta, and cotangent theta equals 1 over tan theta. Okay. Then we have the even odd identities. Sine negative theta equals negative sine theta. Cosine negative theta equals cosine theta. And tan negative theta equals negative tan theta. And lastly, we have the Pythagorean identities. So sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. 1 minus sine squared theta equals cosine squared theta. Tangent squared theta plus 1 equals secant squared theta. 1 minus cosine squared theta equals sine squared theta, and 1 plus cotangent squared theta equals cosecant squared theta. So those are all of the simpler identities. And now for the identities that you should have written down to refer to for this lesson, we have the sum and difference identities. So that's sine A plus B equals sine A cosine B plus sine B cosine A. We have sine A minus B equals sine A cosine B minus cosine A sine B. We have cosine A plus B equals cosine A. Cosine B minus sine A sine B. Cosine A minus B equals cosine A cosine B plus sine A sine B. We have tangent A plus B equals tan A plus tan B plus tan B over 1 minus tan A tan B. And we have tan A minus B, which equals tan A minus tan B all over 1 plus tan A tan B. And those are our sum and difference identities. Now for our double angle identities. We have sine 2a equals 2 sine a cosine a. We have cosine 2a equals cosine squared a minus sine squared a. Cosine 2a also equals 2 cosine squared a minus 1, and it also equals 1 minus 2 sine squared a. For tangent 2a, that equals 2 tan a all over 1 minus tan squared a. Those are the double angle identities. And lastly, we have half angle identities. So sine A over 2 equals plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine A over 2. Cosine A over 2 equals plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine A over 2. And tangent A over 2 has two possibilities, so that is 1 minus cosine A over sine A, as well as sine A over 1 plus cosine A. And that covers all of our identities that we can use to verify identities. Okay, so now that you have them written down, you can refer to them during the lesson. So let's go from easy to hard. Okay, let's cover the steps first. So when verifying trig identities, it is important to follow these steps. So one, You want to convert the identity into forms of sine and cosine. Two, you want to complete fraction math. And three, you want to substitute things for identities. Now, to get to verifying identities. So let's start with an easy one. Cosecant theta over cotangent theta. So, first you want to convert the identity into forms of sine and cosine. This equals secant theta. So now that we have that, we turn it into forms of sine and cosine. So looking at our identities, we see that cosecant turns into 1 over sine theta over cosine theta over sine theta. Now we do fraction math. And so we multiply the numerator by the reciprocal of the denominator. So we take 1 over sine theta times sine theta over cosine theta. And these, of course, cancel out, which gives us 1 over cosine theta. And then looking at our identities, cosine theta, 1 over cosine theta equals secant theta. So secant theta equals secant theta. When it equals the same thing at the end, we know that we verified it. So now for a little bit more of a difficult one, we have secant squared x minus tan x cotangent x equals tan squared x. Okay, this looks like a lot, but it's pretty easy. So, first thing, let's reciprocate cotangent into 1 over tan, so that gives us secant squared x minus tan x times 1 over tan x equals tan squared x. So right off the bat, you see that these can cancel out. So that gives us secant squared x minus 1 equals tangent squared x. And from here, we have two options. We can go the easy route and the harder route. So let's start with the easy way. So if you look at your identities, your notes, you can see that this is a Pythagorean identity, which equals tan squared. And so tan squared x equals tan squared x. There we go. But now, the harder way, we take what we had before, secant squared x minus 1, equals tan squared x, and we convert it into sine and cosine. So this becomes 1 over cosine squared x minus 1 equals tangent squared x. Well, and we can convert this into sine squared x over cosine squared x. And to make it easier, let's change this 1 into cosine squared x over cosine squared x. That way everything has the same denominator. So from here, we subtract this from both sides, so that gives us actually, we don't have to do this. This can stay a 1. Okay, let's cut that out. So to go the harder route, we can say, we can take what we had before, secant squared x minus 1 equals tangent squared x. And we convert it into forms of sine and cosine, so we get 1 over cosine squared x minus 1 equals sine squared x over cosine squared x. So once we have that, we subtract this from both sides, and we add this to both sides. So we get 1 over cosine squared x minus sine squared x over cosine squared x equals 1. After this, we do fraction math, and we multiply both sides by cosine squared x. That way we can cancel out the denominator. So we get 1 minus sine squared x equals cosine squared x. This, of course, is an identity. Cosine squared x equals cosine squared x. Here we go. Now, for another medium one, sometimes when verifying identities, you'll have to FOIL. So let's look at this one. So secant theta minus tangent theta, 1 plus sine theta equals cosine theta. Okay, so we're gonna have to FOIL. So let's multiply the first. So that gives us secant theta outer plus secant theta sine theta minus tangent theta, and then last minus tangent theta sine theta. Okay, equals cosine theta. Okay, now that we have that, let's convert it into forms of sine and cosine. So 1 over cosine theta plus sine theta over cosine theta, because this becomes 1 over cosine theta times sine theta sine over cosine, minus sine theta over cosine theta, minus, this becomes sine theta over cosine theta times sine theta equals cosine theta. Okay, so these subtract each other, so they cancel out. And this becomes sine squared theta. So we get 1 over cosine theta minus sine squared theta over cosine theta equals cosine theta. So from here, we can do fraction math. Again, multiply by cosine. cosine theta, theta, and this cancels out. You get 1 minus sine squared theta equals cosine squared theta. And obviously, this is also an identity. This becomes cosine squared theta equals cosine squared theta. And now we verified yet another identity. And last but not least, the hard one. So, okay, this one looks difficult, but it's not that bad. So 1 plus tangent squared x over cosecant x and secant x equals tangent x. So now, let's follow the steps once again. Convert it into forms of sine and cosine. So 1 plus sine squared x over cosine squared x. Let's actually change this to cosine squared x over cosine squared x so that this is the same denominator. All over 1 over sine x times 1 over cosine x. So let's combine all terms. So cosine times sine squared theta all over cosine squared x. Again, all over 1 over sine x times cosine x. And after this, we are going to multiply the numerator by the reciprocal of the denominator. So cosine squared x sine squared x. Let's erase this so we have more room. Cosine squared x plus sine squared x all over cosine squared x times the reciprocal of the denominator, which is sine x cosine x all over 1. Okay, so right off the bat, this right here is an identity. It's a Pythagorean identity. It equals 1. So we put that over cosine squared x. That's times sine x times cosine x all over 1. We can cancel cosine. This becomes just cosine x. That becomes just sine. So we get sine x over cosine x equals tangent x. And this, again, is another identity. Tangent x equals tangent x. So that's it.